Flight 1143, Cleveland to Dallas, Texas. It landed at 8:16 Dallas time on Monday, October the 13th, a couple of days ago. She has come down with Ebola. At the time she was on that aircraft, however, there were no symptoms seen, and she appeared to be not contagious at that time. Dr. Chuck Emmerman of Metro Health Medical Center told us she must be showing symptoms to be contagious. She apparently was not showing any symptoms. Once we realized that she had been on that flight, that airplane was taken out of the rotation with Frontier Airlines. It is in Cleveland right now. It has been scrubbed down. It has been decontaminated. Healthcare officials tell us that it is now being put back into the Frontier Airlines rotation. That is a good sign that they feel that aircraft is okay. In the meantime, this healthcare worker, not yet identified publicly, is in quarantine at the Dallas hospital where she works as a nurse. That's the latest on the situation. So the Centers for Disease Control is asking anyone who was aboard that aircraft, all 132 passengers, to telephone 1-800-CDC-INFO, 1-800-CDC-INFO, or 232-4636. 800-232-4636, the Centers for Disease Control, which, by the way, is going to hold a news conference coming up. It is coming up at 2 o'clock. No, coming up at 1 o'clock this afternoon in Atlanta, Georgia. Coming up at 2 o'clock here in Cleveland, Ohio, Cleveland City Hall, Cleveland Mayor Frank Jackson, no doubt airport officials, healthcare officials, no doubt will hold a news conference at Cleveland City Hall to update us on how it goes here in Cleveland. That's a 2 o'clock news conference here in Cleveland, Ohio. Let's go back to Nick Foley. He is covering the Hopkins Airport end of the story. Good afternoon, Nick. What more can you tell us?
Thank you, Leon. As you said, we're passing on a lot of information to folks at home based on this story, and understandably, it's a lot to take in, but we're going to focus on the airport side of things. And as you mentioned just a short time ago, it is business as usual here at Hopkins International Airport. That high-ranking official letting me know for the last couple of minutes that passengers are traveling in and out of this airport as scheduled. There are no scheduled or added security or emergency response personnel on site because of the news today. It is normal activity here at Hopkins International. We want to tell you, as you mentioned, Leon, that that plane used on flight 1143 by Frontier Airlines on Monday has been cleaned and decontaminated, and as you said, has been put back in circulation. In fact, we have learned, according to FlightAware, that that plane is scheduled to be flown from Cleveland to Dallas at 4:09 as part of Frontier service in between Cleveland and Dallas on a normal day's activity. So there you go. That flight already scheduled to be used again after being cleaned, or that plane, I should say, scheduled to be used again after being cleaned and decontaminated. Airport officials are confident that there is no threat to anyone else who may be using that plane or flying in and out of the airport from this point forward. So that's the latest here from Hopkins International. I'm Nick Foley, News Channel 5. Back to you, Leon.
Thank you, Nick. I appreciate what you're doing out there. He is keeping us abreast of how it is going with that airplane which has been put back in circulation after it has been segregated from the other aircraft, from the other part of the terminal, and it has been decontaminated. Now, here's what we know about the infected nurse. This just handed me. She traveled to Cleveland, and that infected nurse in Dallas, Texas, is identified as Amber Joy Vinson. Amber Joy Vinson, she is 29 years old. She has active nursing licenses here in Ohio and in Texas. She was visiting her mother in Akron over the weekend. And Amber Joy Vinson lives alone in Dallas, Texas, and currently authorities are decontaminating her apartment there in Dallas, Texas, as she works at that hospital where we had an Ebola patient die just the other day. She apparently had treated that Ebola patient. I want to go to Sarah Butterson in the newsroom. Sarah, what can you add to us right now?
Right, we're still working to gather new information, Leon, but we can tell you that this woman, Amber Vinson, appears to have a nursing license in both Ohio and in Texas. And according to her Facebook page, it looks like she does, in fact, have relatives in the Akron area. We can also tell you that right now, Ohio State health officials are working to identify who she was in contact with while she was in our area. We are also working to identify a discrepancy in the timeline. According to state health officials, she was in our area from October October 8th through the 13th, but according to Frontier Airlines, she flew in on October 10th. So we're working really hard right now to figure out exactly when she arrived in Northeast Ohio. And again, Amber Vincent is the nurse that has been identified in the Ebola case. We are attributing this information to our affiliate WFAA in Dallas, Texas. She again has an active nursing license in Ohio and Texas, and that is according to a state database. And we are still working to gather more information about this woman. If you have any concerns that you came in contact with her or you were exhibiting any signs of Ebola, do contact your health care provider right away and the CDC. Leon?
Well, many thanks for your report, Sarah Buttison. She's been doing wonderful work keeping us abreast of how it is going, certainly in Columbus, as state health officials and city health officials are trying to get their arms around this situation and keep us apprised of how it goes. Let me recap a little bit. This is what we know at this hour. A second healthcare worker in Texas was diagnosed with Ebola. We've just learned that woman flew there from Cleveland to Dallas in the past few days. Right now, authorities are cleaning a Frontier airline airplane at Cleveland-Hopkins Airport. They've just finished cleaning that airplane, and the CDC is trying to contact all the passengers who are on that airplane. We're looking into reports that the patient reportedly had contact with family in Akron. We do know that she is identified as 29-year-old Amber Joy Vincent, and she has a license in Ohio and in Texas. We're told she was visiting her mother in Akron over the weekend. We are uncertain as to how long she was in the Akron area. She could have been here on October, as early as October the 8th, or it could have been as late as October the 10th. Regardless, we are in the process of following up on the story, and authorities are certainly in touch with her mother, no doubt, and other people that she has been in contact with. She was not showing any signs of symptoms at the time that she got on that airplane, which was Monday, October the 13th, flying from Cleveland to Dallas, landing at 8:16 in the evening Dallas time. She showed no symptoms at all, say the flight crew. But still, they want to contact everybody. The CDC wants to contact everybody who was aboard that plane. They have certainly contacted the flight crew. They know who they are. Now they're trying to find all of the passengers, 132 of them, I think is my figure, 132 passengers who are on flight. Flight 1143, Cleveland to Dallas, Fort Worth, on Monday, October the 13th. That woman, Amber Joy Vincent, 29 years old, has a nursing license in both Ohio and in Texas. She was working with an Ebola patient in the Texas area, in Dallas, at that particular hospital. And authorities, we're told, have decontaminated her apartment as well. This is a story that we are continuing to follow. President Obama, who had scheduled to go to New England today on the fundraising campaign trip, has postponed that trip, and he is now meeting with authorities, his cabinet authorities, and they are meeting at the White House talking about Ebola. The state of Ohio continues its preparedness work in university hospitals, Metro Health Medical Center, and other hospitals in Northeast Ohio. Certainly all of them have something in place. No doubt they all have something in place as to how to deal with Ebola if indeed this gets to be a problem. We talked to Dr. Chuck Emmerman, who is over at Metro Health Medical Center. He says there's no reason to panic, but however, we should be prepared. No panic, but be prepared. That is what the approach that is being taken by our hospital authorities right now. Sarah Buttison continues following the story for us in the newsroom. Bring us up to speed on what you have, Sarah.
Right, Leon. The CDC is now stepping up its efforts to Ebola after admitting it could have done more at the beginning. They will now send a rapid response team to any hospital in the country that diagnoses another Ebola patient. Their goal, they say, is to make sure that doctors and nurses are safe, that we don't have any other healthcare workers diagnosed with the Ebola virus. Let's talk a little bit more now about what the CDC is doing in relation to the second healthcare worker who has been diagnosed with Ebola, who was in the Akron area for a few days here over this past weekend. We know that on the morning of October 14th, that is when the hospital worker went to the hospital with a low-grade fever and was isolated. They confirmed that she was on a flight from Cleveland to Dallas that was on October 13th, Monday night, and that flight arrived at 8:16 in Dallas. Right now, the CDC is asking all 132 passengers on that Frontier Airlines flight 1143, Cleveland to Dallas-Fort Worth on October 13th, to call 1-800-CDC-INFO. And at 1 p.m. today, the CDC is going to begin interviewing passengers about that flight. They're going to begin answering their questions and arranging for follow-up. They say individuals who are determined to be any potential risk are going to be actively monitored. This is really important to note because Ebola becomes contagious when the symptoms are present. According to the CDC, the healthcare worker who was diagnosed exhibited no signs or symptoms of illness while on flight 1143, and that is according to the crew. Of course, Frontier is working closely again with the CDC to identify and notify any passenger who was on flight 1143 on October 13th. And I keep repeating this because I want to make sure anybody out there who was on that flight is aware that they need to call the CDC. Leon.
Thank you, Sarah. And once again, we reiterate that you must be showing signs of symptoms. You must be showing symptoms in order to be contagious. And apparently, this woman by the name of Amber Joy Vincent, 29 years old, she was not showing any signs of symptoms at the time she boarded that aircraft in Cleveland for the long flight to Dallas, Texas. I want to bring in Ron Regan right now, one of our investigators, our chief investigator, I should add. Ron Regan, what can you tell us?
Well, we've been looking a little bit into the flight itself, this Frontier Airlines 1143. Where did it come from? How long was it on the ground here in Cleveland before it went on to the Dallas-Fort Worth area? And so what we've learned is this flight, according to some information we obtained from FlightAware, has not been confirmed from Frontier Airlines. But tracking the flight earlier in the day, it left O'Hare Airport in Chicago and landed in Cleveland Monday afternoon. Then at roughly 6:31 in the evening, it was scheduled to take off for the Dallas-Fort Worth Airport. That was about a 2-hour and 36-minute flight, roughly. So those passengers who were on board that aircraft with the individual potentially, and we underscore potentially, were involved or near, could have been exposed, and we don't know that, but that's how long the flight itself was. So again, this aircraft, Frontier 1143, Leon, came from Chicago to the Cleveland-Hopkins Airport, mm-hmm. was on the ground there for several hours in the afternoon before taking off again for the Dallas-Fort Worth area, about a 2-hour, 36-minute flight. And also, we know that the Airbus A320 mm-hmm. Airbus, that particular aircraft is configured to hold a capacity of about 150 people. So we know that there were at least possibly 150, yeah. If the aircraft was at full capacity.
Yes, well, it was 132 passengers, the CDC is telling us, or Frontier Airlines is telling us, 132 passengers. Note, and they're trying to be in touch sure. with all of those 132 passengers. No doubt they have contacted the flight crew. I mean, they know who the flight crew is on Frontier Airlines, sure. and so you were able to uncover this information. I'm wondering if this aircraft is one that back and forth. Is this a shuttle flight?
It is. It appears to be a regularly scheduled flight, mm-hmm. Regular route from Cleveland to the Dallas Fort Worth Airport, and it was in that regular flight where Amber boarded.
Yeah, Amber Joy Vincent, whose mother lives in Akron. She was visiting her mother over the weekend. Now the Cleveland City Hall is going to hold a news conference coming up shortly. I think at the 2 o'clock hour, and Mayor Frank Jackson, and certainly airport officials, perhaps somebody from Frontier Airlines. I would imagine somebody from Frontier Airlines will be there at this news conference in Cleveland City Hall.
Well, I can tell you this: we spoke with a mother-in-law, the mother of Amber's husband, who they have been divorced now for 10 years, according to the ex-mother-in-law. Mm-hmm. She was following this. She has not been called by anyone officially.
Yeah.
She agreed to speak with me, said she has not seen Amber in a number of years, but was extremely concerned to hear what had transpired.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And by the way, we should add that she's the second nurse to come down with Ebola, having treated Mr. Duncan there in the Dallas. The first nurse I'm told who came down with Ebola, I'm told is doing quite well, is doing very well, responding to treatment very well. So, Ron, we appreciate what you've done here, and I know you've
done. You bet. I think the highlight on this, a 2-hour and 36-minute flight down to Dallas.
Okay, thank you so much. Joe Paganiello.